All right, I've got a few tricks up my sleeve to show you guys today. So for those of you that signed up for Email Validator on my website, you may have noticed an interesting interaction here. So on the left-hand side, we've got a very typical email fill-in form. On the right-hand side, I kind of have this image here, which is really just a snapshot of what Email Validator looks like in VoiceFlow. But watch what happens. If we enter an email address, connor.umbral.ai, download, hello. So two things have happened here, okay? One, this image is gone and it is now replaced with a VoiceFlow chatbot. But number two, look, it has the same value that I have entered here in this email form being passed as data into this chatbot. Let's check your email address to see if it's valid. Your input, connor.umbral.ai. And then I just run it through the same flow that I did with Email Validator, which you can check out that video if you click on the bubble that just pops up here on the right. Now, did not make this interactive or anything, because you can see start new chat and the conversation is ended here. So this is not the most functional thing in the world, and it's more of a flex. But I wanted to open this up as a discussion, one, to show you what's going on here, and to two, to show you an actual real live use case of how you might implement this in your chatbot build, because I think this is the direction that we're heading, right? We had a static website page, we entered some information, we clicked a button, hello chatbot. So what is actually going on here? So if we open up the page builder that I use for my website. Now this is WordPress. I'm using a page builder called Live Canvas, which is extremely HTML friendly. And shout out to Daniel, who is working on a parent theme for this particular builder that I am so excited to start using and seeing, because it's got some OpenAI Assistance API integrated, and it's wild. We're gonna have some fun here. Coming months. But anyways, if I click the HTML on my website, and I'll actually like this, and I know those of you that are low code, no code page build or chatbot builders say, oh my gosh, this is code, it's HTML, oh my gosh. Yes, there are no training wheels here, and unfortunately, there aren't going to be any training wheels for the setup that I just showed you, right? Because this is where you decide if you want to stay in chatbot builder land or you want to start getting more into actual web development, because at the end of the day, there aren't going to be these chatbot builders aren't going to hold your hand through this. They're just not. So anyways, what's going on here? So the first thing that I want to kind of call out is this function, which is form state, and it's actually written in Alpine.js. And for those of you that do not know what Alpine is, it's a lightweight JavaScript framework. And one of the reasons I'm using it is to access X data, right? Because I want a data layer that kind of sits in between the website and the chatbot. And that's where that email address gets captured here, which is this dot email here, which is going to be the returns the value of this function. You'll also notice something interesting here. We've got our very standard, typical VoiceFlow script tag that we're used to seeing, but I've got two things in here. And one of them is mode is embedded, which is how you saw it just kind of pop up on the screen here. And then the second thing is this payload. Now, all of the chatbot builders, regardless if it's VoiceFlow, if it's BotPress, if it's chatbot builder, all of them have this functionality to load various payload values into the bot on launch. Okay. So I am opening this VoiceFlow chatbot and saying, hey, here is some data for when you open. So that is what this does. And then the form here, scroll down a little bit more. Where's my form? Here we go. So this X data form state, that's the same name as that function, right? So this form is right here, this email address, and it's passing X data into form state, which is going to call this function call. And then I have submit prevent on here to activate chat, which also prevents you from entering a blank form here, and also calling activate chat, which is another function that's called in here. Excuse me. Okay, so I know I'm going through this quickly. This payload, all right, I have this.email, but here's a variable name that I have constructed, which is email underscore input. If I go into my VoiceFlow build for this particular assistant, for those of you that saw email validator, this is the entire build, right? But look, I have a new block. Is the very first thing that happens, and it is a JavaScript block, and it is taking this payload, which is the last event, and assigning it to that email input variable, okay, which I'm then going to use for the rest of the build. So that is how this gets passed in here through this JavaScript here, because I am actually setting a VoiceFlow variable inside of my build. Excuse me, fighting a cold. I am taking that email address that I've captured with X data and assigned it to a variable, and then I'm overriding it with a VoiceFlow variable. That's how I can use it now inside of this chatbot build. Okay, that is how Connor at Umbral.ai populated in that chatbot window. So if we go back, what else is going on? The embedded here. Okay, so how did I get it to replace that image? So if we go back to this form here, got, nope, the picture. Here, I'll move my face a little bit. All right, so I have a bunch of divs. Then I have this picture element as well, which you can, for those of you that can't read HTML, these are HTML tags here. So the actual element go inside of these tags here. So this is the actual picture. But if we look up inside, one of the parent IDs is chat main, okay, which I have called this chat main. And if I go back up to my VoiceFlow script embedded here, what is the target? Get element by ID, chat main. So I'm calling this ID. All right, VoiceFlow chatbot, you are going to populate this element, which is called chat main. Now, the reason that it replaces this image, if I come back to it, the Z index here is set to 50, which this is a number from one to, infinity, basically. 50 is a high number. Everything else has a base value of Z zero because it's undefined. So this is going to sit on top of this picture. As you can see, this picture script tag is inside of this div. So as soon as that function gets called, it's going to be replaced by chat main, which normally there's nothing inside of it, right? It's an empty div here. Well, it's not empty because it has children, but there's no background, there's nothing inside of it until that function gets called, which then gets overridden by this embedded VoiceFlow bot. Whew. Sounded like a mouthful, and that's because it is. But anyways, this is how you start to set up these types of experiences, right? You have to do custom JavaScript combined with HTML or, whatever builders that you're using or whatever custom, if you're building with React or whatever you're building your website is, this is how you start to interact with these elements and set up this custom functionality. All right, so let me show you another example of this outside of my website in the real world. Now I'm going to blank off the branding of this site because I don't want you chatbot builders blowing up this website because you're not leads. And plus, this is a demo, anyways. So, this is a solar company, right? If I type in an address here, 4705 price, man, ignore the light lettering here. Here we go. Just a random. And we have a $250 electric bill, get estimate. All right, now look what happens. We have this dashboard here that has come up, and we've got on the right-hand side of this dashboard is now a chatbot. I've got a solar estimate, estimated cost, and now I can speak to this estimate here in this chatbot, right? So this is how you can start building unique UX for both the companies that you work for and the users on the other side and integrate it into the business. This is how you build these assistants, right? Now, for the payload for this, I am passing in the home address and the estimated monthly electric bill. And then there's some backend logic that computes this value of the estimated cost for this solar company and stuff like that. So this is, like I said, a demo. You can sit here and ask questions to it. How can I help you? What equipment? And this kind of backs up my statement, which is, I think all websites are kind of heading in this direction, right? The chat as the medium is going to become the preferred way to interact with your customers. And the website and the chatbot information are going to talk back and forth to change what is going on the website. But anyways, once again, if you are interested in picking this stuff up, this is what you kind of have to go through. You have to learn a little bit of JavaScript. You have to learn HTML. You have to learn web design, web development. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean that you need to go pick up a boot camp and learn JavaScript from scratch, but you are potentially going to have to expand your knowledge boundaries and get a little bit uncomfortable and be a little bit dumb in order to try to do things that you've never done before. And for businesses that are looking for this type of, you know, unique bespoke functionality, you start asking for it, right? You reach out to me and say, hey, Connor, I want something like this for my website. Or, hey, chatbot builder that I'm hiring, can you do this? Can you build this for me? And the more that businesses ask for it, the more that the adoption curve is going to increase for both chatbots and this unique UX, where we stop scrolling down to the bottom of web pages, right? And we just have custom rendered elements be fed to us based on what's going on. Anyways, I know that this is kind of short and sweet, and I probably didn't go over some of that as thoroughly as I could have. But anyways, I wanted to show you some of the functionality and some of the stuff that I'm doing on a day-to-day basis. Anyways, talk to you guys later.